Direction. Insane animation. This topic is mind-blowing, and it cannot be omitted, because that is the basis. Without direction, there is no sound animation. There are pictures, transformations, music, etc. But without direction, all these are just a number of separate elements and nothing more. Well, you can see this, unfortunately, in lots of sound works. And telling something useful, helpful about it in such format, I don't know. People learn this for many years, and for most of them that's time wasted. Otherwise there won't be so many clearly poor films, cartoons. One day I was going in a bus. At one of the bus stops, a couple with a baby got on. The baby was just about 2 months. They sat in front of me, the father was holding this baby, and the scene was quite beautiful and touching. The father's strong hands, this little bundle. The mother was really feminine and nice. But for some reason they had worried faces, and both had very sad eyes. However, the scene looked idyllic. So they were sitting, I was looking at them. Then the woman bent to the baby, and I saw a sign behind her back. The name of the bus stop where they got on. Cardio Hospital. Oh, immediately all pieces were put together. It revealed the whole plot. This beauty, this love, this little life, the look of their eyes, and their reason. What are we talking about? About direction, relations between details, objects, images, space in your frame and in your work in general have to tell us about reasons. And these relations of one thing to others contain content. Pay attention, contain. Not create, but contain. They convey what really exists already. Content must be there initially. That is what touched you. That is what excited you. That is what you want to tell about. And you can't but share it with somebody. This is the beginning of your work. If there is no content, and it happens often, don't even start. Not only will you get sucked into a mush of different pictures, you also drag your viewers with you. But when there is an idea, there is content, you are trying to find this particular exact form, how you want to convey it. This is direction. Let's do it this way. In those folders, I've got sketches, notes, scene versions to all projects I've worked with. I've got a habit, when I've finished a piece of work, I need to put the final touch to sort of let it go. I thoroughly clean the studio, wash the floor, air the place, and I compile a folder like this. After each project, there is a pile of different working materials left. I sort it out, throw almost everything away, but I keep about 10-20% of what I think is the most important, valuable, and what might be useful in the future. So there, I've got working materials for all projects, complete and incomplete. Now we are going to look through one of the folders as an example of director's searching process. It might work out a bit chaotic and unorganized, But to tell you the truth, at the moment I don't really understand how to tell about it in a well-structured way. As soon as I understand, I'll remake this episode. Meanwhile, let's move over here. I've chosen a commercial project, another. I think commercial projects are better examples of the process of searching for an idea. Because, as I have mentioned, the beginning of work is your excitement, when you really want to tell about something. That's why when some company or organization comes to me, it's highly important for me to form my personal attitude to them, to feel respect, or pity, or love. I need to feel something. Personally, I need to feel something about them, and I would want to share it with the whole world. And when it happens, then I just look for a form of how to express it. That's why in the beginning, we talk a lot, we meet a lot with the clients, we talk, I ask questions. For me, it's important to understand what global process these people take part in with their activity, and whether they understand it themselves. It's not about making profit or certain services, or market share, etc. These are details. I am not an investor to be interested in all this stuff. I'm interested in other things. I ask, for example, what can a person who is not your client respect you for? Or what good can you do for the world? Yes, of course, often people struggle to leave the boundaries of their usual perception of their business to answer these questions. But if it doesn't happen, I won't be able to start. That's why we meet and talk until it happens. Otherwise, we part. So, there was a bank that asked me to make a short film for them. So, this is a shooting plan, a script, when everything is already found. It's very detailed, planned minute by minute, which camera shoots when, etc. About this later. Here we've got searching for images, those forms, how I'm gonna present the idea. These are just sketches. Here's composition, search of heroes. We'll have a look at it later. This is a scene plan for shooting. How scenes are built, how they change, with lots and lots of comments, adjustments, corrections. We'll have a look at it as well. This is almost final scene order. And here's what I was looking for. I'm not quite sure if it is what we need. Here's my correspondence with a client. For example, in this letter I'm writing that I've got an idea to identify the role of that bank as to help those who are growing and developing. There is a global process of growth and development, and everybody has their role in this process, and I suggest that bank the role of an assistant. For the film, I chose an image for this growth and development. This is a dream, helping achieving a dream. And on this ground, a few slogans for people were born. We can't dream for you, we can't achieve your dream for you, but we can help you in your pursuit. If you have a dream, if you are trying to fulfill it, we can help. Now I'm considering two plots. The first is a story of one hero who gets help and achieves his dream. The second is different stories about realizing a dream and help on the way to these dreams compiled in one film. At some stage I was considering to have a snail as the main hero. I'm writing here, the snail moves slowly but determinedly, stopping in front of obstacles, but it doesn't give up and the author helps it. In this case, the author is hands, which appear in a frame. Here I'm writing about hands. If they appear, when do they appear? What do they do? There must be a rhythm of their participation in the plot, and most importantly, their justification, their reason. For example, they can begin the scene, or end it, or both. They can also create new heroes in a frame. Every new hero will be created by hands. They can appear only in the key moments, etc. Because in this film I was planning to combine animation with hands work, a-la performance, so to say. Where can it move and has the right to move? It's about when these animation fragments appear. Alive or moving can be some fragments, but not the main action. And for example, in the end, here I must have been very pleased as I put three exclamation marks. I wrote Eureka. Of course, the ending, the dream, these fragments was moving. And when heroes achieve it, everything comes alive and starts moving, because they are inside the dream. And the dream has been moving during the film. So it has the right to do it. All the rest is hands and angles. Does the author meet the snail somehow? If yes, then how and when? Is it a snail or not? Eventually it wasn't a snail, it was a girl with a childish drawing, and her dream is to go to the sea. Well, I'm not sure that in this chaotic and unorganized attempt I've managed to tell you something that would make sense for you about direction. However, I hope that I've managed to convey the main ideas, approach and attitude to this search. If we are talking about art, then the main task is to find an image of what you are feeling about something, an image of what you want to share with the viewer, and the response for you will be viewers' feelings about what they see. For example, there's an old Soviet black and white film, Cranes Are Flying. The director found very simple, but very precise images of war. There are almost no military operations, but these images, personally in my heart, arouse feelings about this world's tragedy much stronger and deeper than films about war with battle scenes, torn arms and legs, pardon me, intestines, it's very popular, much stronger. Because there are no images, a director didn't find them, because it's very difficult to find them. This is hard work, this is talent. It's much easier to pile a dumper truck of corpses and impress the viewer this way. It's much more easier. Because you can't invent these images. You can't just sit, concentrate and make them up in your head. You can only find them, search. They already exist. They've been created by nature, by God. They're real and true. The task is to find them. It's like collecting mushrooms. We don't invent, we don't make mushrooms up, do we? We know that they are there, they exist. We only need to find them. We go and look for them. The same is in any creative work, in any art, here as well. But for this, you've got to open your soul really wide. You've got to let so much in of different kind and search among this. Few people are willing to do this. Very few. Otherwise, you won't find anything. And as an example of such openness to the world, I'd like to tell you about one artist. You see that images and situations in his works are impossible to imagine. You can only find them, notice. And for this you've got to look with your eyes really wide open, with a very susceptible soul. Леонид Владимирович Сайфертис, 1911-1996, a Soviet graphic artist. By the way, about war. From 1941 to 1945, Леонид Владимирович worked as a frontline correspondent artist. He was in battle near Одесса, in Севастополь defense, in Малая Земля, reached Berlin, where he celebrated victory. Pay attention to works of his times. They are truly amazing. They show simple everyday situations during war, during this tragedy. He noticed and showed not horrors and death, but life. I don't know, personally, my heart pounds even more because of this.
Леонид Сайфертис. Thank you.